we are beginning cost accounting syllabus with the unit 1 introduction to cost accounting. So these are the contents that we'll be studying. These are the contents that we'll be studying. This is according to the updated syllabus, right? On the third semester BCom under the Bangalore City University. Okay, so according to BCU, this is the updated syllabus. So we're going to be studying the meaning, objectives, importance, functions, differences between elements, cost object, responsibility centers. And we're also going to be solving problems on cost sheet. So introducing this topic, we all know what accounting is, right? And it is subdivided into three major departments or three major specializations, right? Number one, financial accounting. Number two, cost accounting. And then we have management accounting. So in your first semester, you would have studied FA, correct? Financial accounting. Now in the third semester, you'll be studying cost accounting, and later in your third year of BCom, you'll be studying management accounting in detail. So what is financial accounting? As we already know, it is concerned with recording the business transactions in the books of accounts. So FA is simply whatever the business transactions are taking place, you record it in a chronological order. What are the two major documents you prepare under financial accounting? Profit and loss account. That's the number one, which shows how much of profit or how much of loss the company has made during the year. The second statement is balance sheet, which majorly focuses on the financial position of the company on a particular date. Mostly that is the last working date for a company or a organization. So what is the financial year for a company? Starts with April 1st of the current year to March 31st of next year. What is management accounting? It is the practice of identifying, measuring, analyzing, interpreting, and communicating the financial information to the managers for the pursuit of organizational goals. So when we talk about management, breaking that into two words, management and accounting separately, management, what does it do? It makes decisions or choices. Every day, the business have to make decisions or choices. Clear? So management account majorly deals with analyzing, right? All the accounts, whatever you've prepared here in FA, right? All those books of accounts or journals or ledgers or certain statements, the management is going to go through it, right? Analyze the statements, see what is best for the company in the upcoming years in the market, okay? And make the necessary decisions or choices. That is what management accounting focuses on. And next we have cost accounting, right? The subject we are looking at. It is the process of recording, analyzing, and reporting all of the company cost, both variable and fixed, related to the production of a product. As the name itself says, cost accounting, it is focusing upon the cost of manufacture or cost of production of particular product, right? So it records, it analyzes, and reports to the management. Clear? What does cost accounting do, or cost accountant does? He is going to record the transactions, he is going to analyze them and report them to the management. What kind of cost does he analyze or process? Variable cost as well as fixed cost. With relating to what? With relating to production of the product. Clear? If you can look at the picture, can you see that? The major focus of cost accounting is to control the unnecessary cost, okay? Control where it is, you know, you're not putting in too much of your investment, and also cost reduction, because every company wants to achieve minimum cost and maximum profit, or maximizing profit. So what are the major objectives of cost accounting? Number one, I need to ascertain the cost or estimate the cost of production. I need to understand, okay, how much cost does it make or does it involve in order for me to produce a particular product. Number two, control and reduction of cost. That is the major objective. Guys, I want you to remember this. Cost reduction and cost control. These are the major primary objectives of cost accounting. Okay. Cost reduction focuses on minimizing the cost of production. What is cost control? Cost control is making sure that we are avoiding unnecessary expenditures or unnecessary investment. Guides to business policy. Now, since we are focusing upon the cost or elimination of unnecessary costs, it is important and it acts as a policy, as a business policy, right? Because what are we doing? Cost accountant is going to record, process, and report it to the management, which acts as a policy. Determination of selling price, very important. What is the major focus of a business? Maximizing profit. How can I maximize profit? Making sure I have the right selling price. How will I fix the right selling price? Only when I know the cost of production. So selling price equals to cost plus profit margin. Clear to all of you? Selling price equals to cost plus profit margin. Number five, measuring and improving performance. So all the business activities require periodical observation or periodical checking, right? So I need to measure. Keeping this as the cost of production, or keeping a particular cost or particular selling price, how is my business performing, right? I need to check the, or I need to measure the performance. Is there anything lacking? Then I need to improve the performance of my product or product line. Importance of cost accounting. So it is important to understand the classification of cost. So we have direct cost, we have indirect cost, right? Under direct, if we can look into the picture, we have three different things: direct material, direct labor, and direct expenses. Under indirect, we have indirect material cost, indirect labor cost, and indirect expenses. We'll be looking into the detail of these examples. Details of these examples in the upcoming slides. Number two, why is cost accounting important? To control the cost. As I told, availability of finance is not at all a scarcity today. Yes or no? Availability of finance is not at all a scarcity, but how are you utilizing that finance? That holds major importance. So you do not want to waste your money in a wasteful resource. Got it? Therefore, it is important to control the amount of cost the company is incurring. Number three, price determination. As I just mentioned to you, right? How do you fix selling price? First, you get to know your cost of production. Then you add a profit margin. Number four, fixing standards. It is always important for companies and for product lines to have its own standard, right? So I need to understand this is the amount of cost that has to be incurred for producing a particular product. I need to fix that standard, okay? So that people in the lower level of management, right, or lower level of the business, that is the employees or laborers who work in the factory, understand, okay, this is the standard of quality I need to deliver or I need to manufacture in the product. What are the uses of cost accounting? Again, it is helping us in understanding what exactly is the cost of the product. It helps us to control the unnecessary cost. It helps in better decision making. If we understand where the company is wasting or where the company is, putting the money into wasteful resource, it helps us to make a better decisions in the upcoming days of the business. Preparations of budgets, very important. We all need to prepare for our future, right? Even so, companies also have to prepare for their future of their market or of their product line. So they need to be preparing budgets, right? So we'll be solving the problems even on this topic. Identify unprofitable activities. See, the earlier a company identifies, the more resources and time the company can save. Yes or no? If I put money investment into project A and project B is giving the promised returns, okay? But project A, it gave me promised returns only 1 year. The second and the third year following, it did not give me any promised returns. In fact, I'm incurring losses from that particular project. Understand? So therefore, which is profitable and which is unprofitable here? Project A is unprofitable and project B is profitable. So I need to be quick in identifying which is an unprofitable activity or project.